have seen the applications of CAD and CAM, and we have seen the subject what topics will be there, and now we'll be seeing the overview of CAD. So CAD is computer aided design or drafting. So by using the CAD software, we can able to perform 2D vector based drafting and 3D solid and surface modeling. Next, newer models. In the newer models of the packages, that is the CAD newer version, in that you are able to do not only the 2D and 3D and also the rotations in 3 dimensions is possible with the latest versions, allowing the viewing of design object from any angle. Next, so it is capable of also performing in the later versions the dynamic mathematical modeling. So which is nothing but CAD, computer aided design and drafting. So in the next point of overview, you can see that by using the design of tools, different tools are there, modifier tools, commands, everything will be used in this drafting. So by using the design of tools and machinery, drafting and design of all types of buildings, that is by architecture also, it is more adaptable, and along the same time for the mechanical design like gearing systems, gear wheels, flywheels, and models of automobile, everything it is able to do by this CAD software. Next, for architecture also it is being used. So what are the advantages by using the CAD software? It is very precise. It is very precise, and in detail you can able to understand, and it also having a 3D detailed drawing. 3D detailed drawing in all the 3 dimensions, in all the 3 X, Y and Z axis rotation. And you can also resize easily any of the calculation, and it is easier to adopt and more economical and computerized model. So once it is done, the draft is being saved and you can use at any further references, and also you can modify the drawing which is already be done, for example in dimensions like that. And coming to disadvantages of CAD, here the recurring cost of software. Every software needs a license and every software is to be updated. So in that, recurring cost will be included, that will be certain expensive and time consuming. And when coming to initial cost of buying the computer systems, every person need a computer to do any of the software. So in mechanical software, so you have to use the computer system, which is a certain economical for normal people. And information can be instantly lost if it is being corrupted. If it is being corrupted, it should be formatted. So at that time what happens, the saved draft may be lost. So next, how it works. So first, the product is considered by the engineer. Which product we want to do, which product we want to produce, that must be conceived, it must be considered, and then the product is designed by using any of the CAD softwares with dimensions and all, providing dimensions. And CAD data is transferred to the manufacturing machines industry by using the CNC, computer numerical control. So by this, the computer is being integrated with the manufacturing by using its machine language. Next, machine uses the CAD data to produce the product with limited human involvement. Next, let us see the list of few softwares. CAD software for architectures. This will be more adaptable. That is ArchiCAD. Next, AutoCAD is there for mechanical people, and Autodesk Inventor, and AutoTurn, AutoCAD work, and Constructor. Like that few NX High Design, like that few design softwares are there. Accordingly, we can use for the required purpose. Next, what is CAM? Computer Aided Manufacturing. So, in computer aided manufacturing, the conventional or the traditional manufacturing processes are being done with the help of a computer. By adopting a computer technology, that is the computer technology, we are able to do the manufacturing, and every tool movement is provided by, to the machine tool by certain codes, by certain G and M codes by CNC. So CAM engineers Similarly, use computer modeling to determine the best overall manufacturing procedures for use in industry plant, including testing and handling of finished products will also be done by using this. If you will be seeing in FMS, flexible manufacturing system, all the things were handled by single computer. Even the testing, inspection, manufacturing and design, everything is done by a single control unit. Next, engineers can use CAD and CAM together to create a design in CAD in one computer, then transmit the design to the next computer for doing the CAM operation. So CAD is being done in the drafting and then it is being converted into the NC code. Each and every movement is being given a code and that is being used in CAM for which is further connected to the machine tools. Next, it is being defined as the use of computer software to control machine tools and related machinery in the manufacturing of work pieces. Or it can also be defined, or it can also be explained as an application technology where it uses the computer software along with machinery to facilitate automated manufacturing processes. Next. So when we are not adopting computer, how the manufacturing process is being conducted? Each person should be first, he is allowed to know or to have a skill, or he is being trained regarding the manufacturing processes and how he should work at the machine tool and all. So individually the work process will be done on each and every workpiece, each and every job. So every time what happens, the time lapse is taking place and there is a defective pieces are more and the material is being wasted. So all those things are eradicated by using a computer, adopting a computer in CAM, that is computer aided manufacturing. The product is designed with CAM software. For CAM also there are certain softwares, not only for CAD but CAM also, and product specifications are sent over the plant network to machine. To each machine. Next, machines, by using its intelligence, it is able to produce the product with or without the human interference. Next, CAM uses. So one of the primary use of CAM software for creation of machine toolpath. So 2D toolpath will be there and 3D toolpath will be there. In 2D, the finishing and roughing operations can be done. Well, coming to 3D, you can do in all the three directions. So more adaptable. So this is the part in which cutting tool will take the cut over the material in most efficient manner to save time and achieve the closest result to the finished product. So the main thing is accuracy is being attained. So accuracy is being attained by using the computer while comparing to the human resources. In 2D tool part, you can see the roughing and finishing operations here. So a roughing toolpath is generally used in CAD/CAM, that is by using a CNC programming, using removing of material will be done in roughing. So we are able to remove more amount of thickness of the material. Well, coming to finishing, you can also do for a minute mm of material removal also, or reaming type of operations which is already being drilled, that is being drilled. Reaming operations also can be done. Very smooth finishing, like grinding, can also be done by using this type of CAM software. Next, 3D toolpath. So 3D toolpath, not on wire medium, wire electron discharge machining, the hairpin like structure will be there. That hairpin tool will be removing the material over the surface of the workpiece. So like that, you can also be used this type of 3D part material removal in water jet machining and precision operations, like with minimum operator involvement. Next, so what are the advantages? Increases the productivity. Finally, what we require? We must have an economical and a high productive rate. So increased productivity, error-free drafting. I already specified the errors will be minimized. It will be there, but at a minimal. Next, repeatability. If one product is done, again the next product is ready for the operation, and then the next product. Next, three-dimensional modeling can also be done very easily by using CAM and lower overhead cost, and gives us zoom feature. That is, camera means how much the lens is having, that much precision you can able to see the operation and able to do the operation in a pixel manner. Next, design can alter very easily. If you want to change any of the dimension, you can change in the program and you can also again give it for the manufacturer. Limitation. So what are the limitations? The software is very expensive. It will be in thousands. So which may not be adaptable for everyone. And special skill is required. He must be able to have the idea of the software and he must be able to do the machining operation. Next, expensive machine requirement. The machine itself very costly compared to the conventional or the traditional type of machines. Next, high maintenance. Maintenance cost will be there. It must be lubricated all the time. Lubricants must be provided against. Next, nature of the material of the object. Depending upon the material of the object, the operation will be, the tool will be changed and the operations are also adopted. So what are the CAM softwares? DelCAM, which is one of the famous one, Tebes and Vero software. You can use Simatron, GibbsCAM, like that, few of the names of the softwares just to make you idea of it. Next, typical areas where this type of CAD and CAM can be used is in automation of machining processes, and where you can also attain the ease of use. It is just you have to know the idea of the software and know some of the commands, then it is easily be done. Next, future recommendation and machining and multifunctional machining. At a time, you can do many operations which cannot be performed by a single person. So CAD-CAM applications both. So in the further 5 units, you will be able to see the CAE, computer aided engineering. In engineering, how the computer is being played a main role, it is being explained there. And computer aided analysis, mathematical calculations, which is nothing but analysis. CIM, how the computer and the machine tool is being integrated, that is computer integrated within the manufacturing. And CNC, computer numerical control, and CAP, computer aided process planning, CAPP. So the process of from the raw material to the final product, that route sheet is also be done. That route sheet is also be done with the help of a computer. And the quality check of the final product is also be done, CAQC. Next, superimposition of the objects can also be added. So where all the industries which can adopt this CAD-CAM software or CAD-CAM application is automotive industry, automobile, aerospace industry, even in fiber, textile industry, medical. Medical, we are using different instruments within the medical industry also. That instruments can also be done. Next, video gaming industry and welding and cutting and die manufacturing, dice to make the die. So need for CAD-CAM. So why we need CAD-CAM, which is already I have told you previously. And coming to conclusion of the CAD-CAM, so less chances of error can be made, more reliable. The software is more reliable. You can use hundreds of times. It is more reliable and both work done with proper calculations. Human can make some errors, but not the machines. So most of the errors can be rectified there. And both CAD and CAM can be used at any point for the industry which I have mentioned there. Next one is flexible manufacturing system. So let us have an introduction of flexible manufacturing system, where all the applications which I have told you, CAE, CAPP, CAQC, all those are you are able to see at one point, which is nothing but the computer is more flexible with respect to the manufacturing systems. So this is the history of FMS. So initially, first conceptualized for machining, it required the prior development of NC. So first NC must be developed, that is numerical control, then only you can adopt. Next, this concept is credited to your son, a British engineer during mid-1960s. Next. So this is the layout of FMS. So it consists of raw material, will be continuing in the next.